We are back with this all new at 4:30. The problem solvers digging deeper into Denver Public Schools policy when it comes to safety plans as students return from spring break.
Now, this comes after a student on a safety plan brought a gun to East High School in Denver and shot two administrators, then took his own life. Problem solver Alex Rose joins us in the studio with the questions we're asking today. Alex.
Matt, how many students are on safety plans that require them to be padded down for guns across Denver Public Schools? That's the main question we've been asking. And according to DPS, they don't track that on the district level. A spokesperson says each school maintains their own records. We've asked how many students are padded down for guns at East High School, and we're still waiting for the district to give us that answer. We know there are more than 870 requests for safety plans just this school year, but the district says it's hard to nail down how many active safety plans are district-wide because the number is always changing. Safety plans can be for a number of different issues, think suicidal thoughts or possession of drugs. Here's Denver School Board of Education Vice President Ayante Anderson on Colorado Point of View to explain the issue.
These searches don't just happen without the student's consent and without family knowledge. So the student's family is involved in the crafting of the safety plan. So the safety plans, it can go anywhere from a vape pen to marijuana to suspected of a weapon. But we are not just instituting safety plans just for the hell of it.
So the problem solvers have asked, since the district doesn't track how many students are being padded down for weapons across the board, are there any plans to change that policy and track that district-wide? We've still not heard back from DPS on how it will approach this issue moving forward. Alex Rose, Fox 31.